Hey guys, this is Malinki. Welcome back to my channel, Voice of Malinki. So today we will talk about fertilization in sea urchin. If you are new in my channel, please subscribe my channel. And if you like my video, please do like, comment and share my video. Let's talk about fertilization in sea urchin. So sea urchins are marine animals. They undergo external fertilization. They release their gametes, so gametes are sperm, ova, so they release their gametes in the seawater. So the fertilization in sea urchin consists of four steps. So first step is sperm attraction. As long as sperm cells are in the testes of the animals, they experience a low pH, that is 7.2. Because the environment of testes has the pH, that is 7.2. When sperm are released into the seawater, sperm pH is elevated to 7.6. This high pH activates dynein ATPase. Activated ATPase cleaves ATP into ADP and PI and release energy. This energy enables flagella to wave and the sperm begins swimming vigorously. But the ability to move does not provide the sperm proper direction toward egg or ovum, you can say. So direction is provided by a chemotactic protein, that is RESECT, that is released by sea urchin eggs. Sperms have receptors in their cell membrane that bind RESECT. These receptors are guanylyl cyclase or GC. When RESECT binds GC, it makes GC activated. Activated GC makes cyclic GMP or cGMP from GTP. So we will see it in an image, so the thing will be clear. So here we can see that this is sperm cell membrane, and this membrane contains a receptor, that is GC. So this is GC receptor. And this receptor binds RESECT, and this RESECT is secreted from egg. So when RESECT binds GC, it makes GC activated. And the activation of GC will make cGMP from GTP in the cytosol. So cGMP activates a calcium channel, allowing the influx of calcium ions from the seawater into the sperm, thus providing direction for the sperm. Thus, upon meeting RESECT, sperm are instructed where to go. So here you can see that when cGMP or cyclic GMP is produced, it will activate this calcium channel, and this calcium channel will allow the influx of calcium from seawater into the cytosol, and the increased amount of calcium will show the direction toward egg. Next step is acrosome reaction. So before understanding the acrosome reaction, we need to know about the structure of egg and sperm. So this is the egg of sea urchin. This is cytoplasm, and plasma membrane is surrounding the cytoplasm. And outside the plasma membrane, they have one more layer, that is vitelline envelope. That is extracellular matrix, and that is vitelline envelope. Around vitelline envelope, they have jelly layer, that is the extracellular coat. So they have three covering. First one is plasma membrane, second is vitelline envelope, third is jelly layer. And inside the cytoplasm, just beneath the plasma membrane, they have cortical granules. In the sperm, acrosome is present in the sperm head. So acrosome is a special kind of organelle with a cap-like structure located at the anterior portion of the head of the sperm. So this is acrosome. The acrosomal reaction is initiated by the interacting of sperm cell membrane with a specific sulfate containing polysaccharide in the egg jelly. So the egg jelly contains a specific sulfate containing polysaccharide, and this polysaccharide will interact with the sperm cell membrane. When this sulfated carbohydrate, that means this sulfate containing polysaccharide, binds to its receptor on the sperm, the receptor activates three sperm membrane proteins. First one is a calcium channel that allows calcium to enter the sperm. Second is a sodium hydrogen exchanger that pumps sodium ions into the sperm and hydrogen ions out. Third is a phospholipase enzyme that makes inositol triphosphate or IP3. And IP3 is able to release calcium from endoplasmic reticulum. The elevated calcium level in the cytoplasm releases enzymes and triggers the fusion of the acrosomal membrane with the adjacent cell membrane. So when the calcium level is increased in the sperm, they will help to release some enzymes, and those enzymes will trigger the fusion of the acrosomal membrane with the adjacent sperm cell membrane. So here you can see that this is the sperm cell membrane and this is the acrosomal membrane. So if this is acrosomal membrane and this is the cell membrane, so there will be the fusion between these two membranes. Elevated calcium level in the cytoplasm mediates the polymerization of actin molecules. The actin polymerization induces the extension of the acrosomal process, makes a fertilization cone. So when the calcium level is increased in the sperm, in the cytoplasm of sperm, it will mediate the polymerization of actin molecules. And those actin polymerization induces the extension of the acrosomal process. That will make a fertilization cone. So here you can see that this is the sperm. And here actin polymerization took place, and it is making the acrosomal process, that is specifically a fertilization cone, because it's like a cone shape. Binding is a protein located in the sperm acrosome process. So here you can see these proteins are binding proteins that are present in the sperm acrosome process, and they mediate the adhesion of sperm to egg plasma membrane. So here we can see that how egg sperm fusion takes place. So here we can see that in this way, the binding, it is located in the sperm acrosome process, it will mediate the adhesion of sperm to egg plasma membrane. So this is egg plasma membrane and it is getting fused with the sperm. Next we will see the first block to polyspermy. So the entrance of multiple sperm into a single egg is lethal for the development of zygote. Only one sperm should fertilize one egg always. So to prevent these undesirable incidents or polyspermy, sea urchins undergo some events. So the first block to polyspermy is achieved by changing the electrical potential of the egg cell membrane. This membrane provides a selective barrier between the egg cytoplasm and the outside environment, so that ion concentrations within the egg differ greatly from those of its surroundings. Seawater has a high sodium and low potassium concentration, whereas egg cytoplasm contains low sodium and high potassium concentration. These concentration differences are maintained by the cell membrane, which inhibits the entry of sodium into the egg cytoplasm and prevents potassium from leaking. This resting membrane potential is minus 70 millivolt because the inside of the cell is negatively charged with respect to the exterior. So this is the egg of sea urchin and this is the plasma membrane. So here you can see this is sodium channel and this is potassium channel. And in the seawater you will get high sodium concentration and low potassium concentration, and in the cytosol here you will get low sodium concentration and high potassium concentration, and the cytosol remains negative and the sodium channel and potassium channels are now closed. Within 1 to 3 seconds after the binding of first sperm, some sodium channels open and influx of sodium occurs in the egg cytoplasm. Hence the membrane potential shifts to plus 20 millivolt. So what will happen after 1 to 3 seconds of sperm binding? Some sodium channels that were closed, now they will open. An influx of sodium occurs in the egg cytoplasm. So sodium will enter in the egg cytoplasm from the seawater. As now the sodium concentration is high in the cytoplasm, the membrane potential shifts to positive, that is plus 20 millivolt. Sperm can only fuse with egg cell membranes when the membrane potential is minus 70 millivolt. They cannot fuse with membranes having a positive membrane potential. So no more sperm can fuse to the egg. First block of polyspermy is a transient event. It does not last for longer as membrane potential reaches its optimum very soon. Now the slow block to polyspermy will come in action. Upon binding of binding and its receptor, a tyrosine kinase TK is activated. That in turn activates a phospholipase C or PLC. So we will see here that in this case the binding, these are now fused with the egg cell membrane, because egg cell membranes contain the sperm receptor and it binds with the binding. When it occurs, tyrosine kinase or TK gets activated and that will activate PLC, phospholipase C in this case. PLC clips PIP2 into DAG and IP3. So the full form of PEEP2 is phosphatidyl inositol 4,5-bisphosphate. DAG is diacylglycerol. IP3 is inositol 1,4,5-triphosphate. So you can see here that PLC is cleaving PEEP2 into DAG and IP3. IP3 binds IP3 receptor on endoplasmic reticular membrane. That in turn mediates release of calcium from ER to cytoplasm. Hence, the concentration of free calcium increases in the cytosol. So, in this picture, you can understand this. So, PLC cleaves PEEP2 into DAG and IP3. IP3 will bind the IP3 receptor in the endoplasmic reticulum. When IP3 binds IP3 receptor, calcium ions will be released into the cytosol of egg. Directly beneath the egg cell membrane, cortical granules are located. So that we have seen in the previous picture that beneath the cell membrane, cytosol contains cortical granules. In a high calcium environment, so we have seen that in this case, the calcium concentration is high in the cytosol. So in the high calcium environment, these cortical granules fuse with the egg cell membrane and release their contents into the space between the cell membrane and white line membrane. So we have seen that egg is covered by three membranes. First one is plasma membrane, second one is white line membrane. Now when the calcium concentration is high in the cytosol, the cortical granules that are present beneath the plasma membrane, they will fuse with the plasma membrane and they will release their contents because these cortical granules contain some proteins, enzymes, hydrolytic enzymes, etc. So they will release their contents into the space between cell membrane and white line membrane. Several enzymes are released. They cleave the proteins. Connect the white line membrane to the cell membrane. So the cell membrane or plasma membrane of the egg is connected with the white line membrane via some proteins. Those proteins will be cleaved by the enzymes that are released from cortical granules. Among those proteins, one is binding receptor. So binding receptor is one of the proteins. So as it gets cleaved, so binding receptor is also cleaved by those enzymes that are released from the cortical granules. Sperms cannot attach egg further because we know that binding receptor is the receptor that helps the attachment, that actually binds sperm. Because binding receptors bind in the sperm, and these binding receptors are now cleaved. So, no any binding receptors are present in the ovum. As these receptors are cleaved, sperms cannot attach egg further. So, this is all about fertilization in sea urchin.